Hi, this is Susan Haynes, and this is Fall 2011. I want to give a really abbreviated introduction to the idea of state transitions, mostly as an aid to my students who are learning about regular expressions. So I'm going to do this by basically going through a number of examples. And the first example that I have here is that I want to write code that will recognize a string that has two characters from this set, followed by one character from this set right here. So an example possible string might be AA dot. Another possible string might be BC pound. Another one possible might be AC dot. Those are all okay. Not okay would be ABC. Also not okay would be pound AB. Okay, so we can see our different things that are possible and not possible. So let's go ahead first and draw the state diagram to talk about this. There are two ways of representing the code that we're going to write to find, well, that would be written to find this, either in a state diagram or in a state table. And you can go with either one that you want in order to develop it first, but you can easily translate between either of these two representations, the state diagram right here or the state transition table right here. So I want to do this, recognize a string that is two characters from here followed by one character from here, and then I have success. So for the state transition diagram, I'm going to start in an initial state that I'll just label init right here. And I'm going to draw this arrow to indicate that this is the state that we start in, the init state. Now, there will be different inputs that will be read. They are coming from this alphabet, A, B, C, pound, period, or pound. So if I have an A, B, or C, then I want to go to my next state right here, which means in this state right here, I have discovered one of A, B, or C. Okay, let me just call this state A for convenience. Now I need to recognize one more character from state A. I need to have one more character from this set A, B, or C. So let's call that the state B. So that's what my input looks like, A or B or C. Okay, once I'm in A, or once I'm in state B, capital B here, I need to have as in the very next input either a dot or a pound. So let's take that, a dot or a pound. And if I'm in that state, then I'm done with success. I'll just call that okay. And I'm going to circle that state to indicate I have successfully matched the pattern that I'm looking for. Okay, now obviously I'm not done here because I haven't considered all possible paths out of a particular state, but I have these four states so far, init, A, B, and OK. Usually you want to name it with something either short or descriptive. So from the init state, if I have A, B, C, I went to state A, capital A. If on the other hand, I'm in the init state and I have a pound or a dollar, I don't want to go to state A. I want to go to another state which says fail. So that is my pound or dot. Did I say dollar? Sorry, dot. Okay, now if I'm in the A state here, I receive an A, B, or C. I go to the B state, so I'm still possibly able to match the string. However, if I receive a dot or a pound, that's a fail. Okay, here if I'm in the B state and I receive a dot or a pound, I've successfully found what I'm looking for. On the other hand, if I receive an A or a B or a C, I go into the fail state. Okay, now the fail state is also a terminating state. Once I've failed, then I don't need to continue any further with the particular string that I'm examining for the successful pattern. So let's just trace around with, let's say, a successful pattern right here and see if we end up in the OK state. So I'm going to trace AC dot. So I start in the init state, I get an A, so I transition to capital A state. I then get a C, so I transition to the capital B state. I then get a dot, So I transition to the OK state. All right, let's do AA dot. Okay, start in the init state. I get an A, so I transition to capital A state. Next character is an A, so I transition to the capital B state. Next character is a dot, so I transition to the OK state. All right, let's try something where we're going to fail. ABC. Okay, I start in the init state. I get an A, so I go to the capital A state. I get a B, so I go to the capital B state. I go to the C, so I go to the fail state. All right? So we can see that this state transition diagram, it's commonly called state transition diagram. State diagram is kind of a shorthand. This state diagram successfully describes the steps I have to take to recognize my desired pattern or realize that the desired pattern is no longer possible. So let us go ahead and make the state transition table. Now I have two states that I'm representing here, and the first column right here is the start state, and then this second set of columns here will be the resulting state. So for instance, from init to A, this is the start state, this is the resulting state. From init to fail, this is the start state, this is the resulting state. And which state I go to depends on what my input is. Okay, so when I start at init, well, I can just copy down all my states here because they all have to end up somewhere. So I have init, A, B, OK, and fail. Init is my start state, and OK and fail are my sink states, my terminus state. So let me indicate that with my little little graphical notation here. Okay, so if I'm in an init state and I get as input A, I go to capital A state. If I get input B from an init state, I go to capital A. If I'm in an init state, I get C, I go to capital A. If I'm in an init state and I get a dot, I go to fail. I better abbreviate that with an F, okay, because I don't have room. If I'm in an init state and I get a pound, I go to fail. Okay, now when I'm in A state and I get an A or B or C, I go to state B. A or B or C, I go to state capital B. If I'm in A and I get a dot or a pound, I go to state fail. All right, if I'm in B state and I get an A or a B or a C, I go to state fail. Fail, fail, fail. If I get a pound or a dot, I go to state OK. State OK and state fail are terminal states, so that means I can end there, plus there's no other input that's necessary. I've recognized my string, so in this case I'm just not going to continue. You'll see for a later example that it is possible to move on out of the terminal state and sort of what circumstance that would happen in.